Disclaimer, this video is not sponsored.
Hey everyone, today I'm going to be repairing this Switch Lite I got recently for 70 Canadian Tire dollars. Part of why I got this so cheap is it has some messed up joysticks. One of them kind of looks like someone got a little hungry, as it's completely gone. To get these sticks back in working order, I'm going to be using these Hall FX joysticks I got online. Powering on the system, we can see it's still working. The left joystick works, and the snapped off one makes a noise when pressed, so we know it's most likely just physical damage. We're now going to power down the system and take off the protective case. You can see it's pretty dirty, so I'm going to wipe it off a bit before we open it up. Alright, now I actually feel like I can touch this thing. You can see the case left some markings on the back. Hopefully that's showing up. Anyway, we're gonna start taking out screws from the shell using a TriPoint Y00 screwdriver and a JIS 000 Phillips screwdriver. I'm now gonna use a guitar pick to split the case apart, starting at the speaker, going around the edges of the console until the back comes free from the front. Now we can take off the heat shield. We're then going to disconnect the battery by pulling out these two connectors. The ribbon cable will have a lever you need to flip up with your nail or a spudger. The second connector, I just shoved a zip tie underneath and pulled upwards. Now that the battery is disconnected, we're going to start on the left joystick and disconnect the speaker connector using tweezers. Don't pull on the wires or they will rip out. With the speaker disconnected, we can now unscrew this screw right here and remove it from the chassis. We're now going to disconnect all four ribbon cables connected to the board. Once that's done, we can now unscrew and remove the left trigger. We're then going to unscrew the board from the chassis and lift it out. Now we can unscrew the old joystick and replace it with the new one. Once it's installed, we need to put everything we just took out back in. Alright, now that we're done the left side, we're gonna start on the right side. First, we're gonna remove the heatsink, starting with the foam. We just need to peel it back enough so we can lift the heatsink out of the console. If it's really stuck on there, you can also just make a small cut in it like I did. Next, we will take the screws out from around the die and lift the heatsink out. Now, we're gonna disconnect this ribbon cable from the game card reader, remove the screws securing it, and put it aside. We can then unscrew and remove the right trigger, and now we just need to disconnect the Wi-Fi antennas, the fan, and these two ribbon cables for the screen and the digitizer. And finally, we're going to disconnect the ribbon cable from the joystick. Now we can unscrew the motherboard from the console's shell and lift it upwards, giving us access to the joystick. Same as before, we're going to unscrew and replace the old joystick and screw in the new one. With all that done, it's now time to redo the thermal paste and put everything back together. With everything back together, it's now time to turn it on and test it out. Okay, everything seems to be working good. I believe that's a wrap. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments below. And if you want to support the channel, leave a like, comment below, or check out some of the other cool stuff I've made. Hope this video helped you or was entertaining in some way. With all that said, I'm Kilby Shobra, and I hope to see you in the next video. Peace!